Let us look at analogical retrieval more closely. Once again, we have come across this idea earlier. We did analogical retrieval in recording cases by the k-nearest neighbor method. We did analogical retrieval in case-based reasoning using two different methods, the array method and the discrimination tree method. Here, the criteria for evaluating similarity were very clear, as we discussed earlier. Euclidean distance, same tags, as well as placement in this discrimination tree. The question now becomes, what criteria should be used to decide on the similarity between the target problem and the source case, given that they come from different domains? On surface, there seems to be little similar between the two. None of the objects is similar. None of the values or features is similar. Yet, there is a deep similarity there. We can distinguish now between superficial similarity between two situations and deep similarity between two situations. Superficial similarity deals with features of objects or counts of objects or objects themselves. Deep similarity deals with relationships between objects or sometimes relationships between relationships. Examples of this arise from the Raven's test with which you're already familiar. Features here refer to the size of the square, the size of the circle, or perhaps whether it's a hollow square or a solid dot. The count refers to the number of squares or the number of circles in a particular image. Objects here refer to circles and squares and dots. Let us look at relationships between objects. Two situations are said to be deeply similar if the relationship between the objects is similar. As an example, A and B are similar in that the dot is outside the circle here and the square is outside the circle here. A and B are also similar in that the dot is above the circle here and the square is above the circle here. What about relationships between relationships? Let us compare A and B. In going from A to B, the dot has disappeared and the square has come outside the circle and become bigger. Now we can compare this relationship between A and B with some other relationship between a C and a D, in which too, some object might be disappearing and another object which was in the center of the circle comes out of the circle. I'm sure you have come across problems like that on the Raven's test. This is an example of a binary relationship, a relationship between two objects. This is an example of a higher order relationship, a tertiary relationship, if you wish. This is a relationship between relationships between objects. You might even say that these are examples of unary relationships. These are just examples of objects and their features and counts. In general, as we go from unary relationships to binary relationships to tertiary relationships to even higher order relationships, the similarity becomes deeper and deeper. This means that mind decides two situations to be more similar if the similarity is at the level of relationship between objects rather than simply at the level of objects or features or counts or objects.